My bad. I was thinking why. Why was my my audio level so quiet? And it's because the music was playing at half volume. It's fine. Anyway, hi. He needs some chocolate milk. Right, well, we're back to normal streaming after what I believe is a successful D&D session. yeah, after what I think is a successful D&D session. I think I'm gonna upload the full VOD at some point later, but I've left it to one of the guys to see if they want to do any editing with it. Hello, Bast. How you doing, mate? You alright? What the fuck is that? Oh. Legend of Mockers. Do some more on December tonight as well if you want, mate. Oh dear. Let's I don't know what that's gonna do. Let's run away. Sounds good. Sweet. Caroline. Oh. Oh. I got panicked for nothing. Yum. Tear? What's that for? Stop crying. Little wah-wah in it. That was my first game ever. I think so, anyway. Actually, no, it wasn't. No, that's a lie. That was my first game ever. Easy. Son of a bitch. Owie. Fox. Can we land an attack? Find out next time. What a lucky bitch. Crit me through the blind. There we are. Is that one of my missions? Oh, maybe not. Oh no. Meow, 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 meow. You little bitch.
That's that then. Let's move out.
Chest. Nice. this road has been ruined by the monsters. I'm a comedy genius. Oh, whoa. Wow, so this room, or room one, whatever, this is one gorgeous city. The blue water and white buildings do make for a nice contrast. Certainly feels like a border city. Haha. Well, it promises many varied things. There's a lighthouse not far from here, in a little park on the coast. On the other side of town, there's a pretty neat looking church too. But the biggest attraction of all has to be Langland Bridge. What's so special about it? It connects the north and south districts of the city. And more importantly, it's a drawbridge. A drawbridge, huh? Yeah, it might be interesting. The Racer Guild is just past there, in the middle of the main street. Just in front of the bridge. Okay then, let's go there first. That's a fat no from me. Excuse me. So that would cost me 5, 10, 15. Kitted out with gear. To go find the ornament shop. Yo, what up? Right, everyone has all the slots. Poison mute. Some cool things in there. see you. Last kiss from Rose, isn't it? Clock up, EX. I'm gonna go with that, I think. Try it out in it. Good afternoon. Oh, it's a receptionist. Oh, hello there, can I help you? Jean or Jean is currently in a meeting with a guest on the second floor. Sorry for the inconvenience, but is there something I can help you with? Well, we're not here as customers or anything. Oh, the emblems, I see. My name is Karna. I work here at the Ruin Branch. Are you in town? I don't recognize you. Yep, I'm Estelle, Junior Bracer. Same goes for me. I'm Joshua. It's a pleasure to meet you. Estelle and Joshua? That's right, you and the new kids from Ronin, then. You two were involved in some big to-do which Charizard was there, weren't you? Well, I don't know if I'd put it quite like that. Were you expecting us? Yes, Jin told me about some promising up-and-comers. I'm afraid you can't change assignments until he's available. Why not go sightseeing to kill some time for them? I suppose so. Be sitting around and waiting. Totally with you. Oh, yeah. Would you want to hang out with us a little more? We only just met, and I'd hate to just parch you suddenly. Ah, certainly. As long as I won't be able to get in your way. Woohoo! Out to them. We can all go take in the sights of Ruin, and then we'll come back in a little bit. Sure, have fun. Got O'Neill. Telling you the news books I'm buying. I missed one. Oh my god, the end of the world is here. Oatmeal, yes. Why did you just say oatmeal?
Oh, right, O'Neill, sorry. I was hoping I could buy like a signature dish or something. Learn this recipe. Hang on. This way is the park built to commemorate the end of the Hundred Days War. Okay, I have a question for everyone. As you know, you'll be right in front of the Royal Palace if you cross the Ruby River. That's where the ships of the Imperial Navy were defeated during the Hundred Days War. How was it done? I know. Go ahead. Heh, I got it. Too easy. They used the cannons that are all over Ruin City, right? Not quite. Actually, there's plenty of artillery here, but we still can't withstand a heavy Imperial attack on that alone. I'll give you a hint. They employed a much more dynamic method. I know, I know. And go. What's the answer, miss? They lowered the Langland Bridge? Oh, so sorry, that's incorrect. Power to the city had been knocked out at the time. Here's the answer. Many old and decommissioned ships were sent from upriver to be detonated and sunk. Since the mouth of the river is so shallow, the Imperial ships couldn't break through. Wow, that's cool, but it seems a little bit much. Extreme, if you ask me. Well, we're done for the day now, so you're free to do as you wish for a while. Please have fun, it's time. Hotel Blanca. Oh. Whoa, this is the Langland Bridge? Sure is huge. It's gotta be twice as big as the Vert Bridge. It was built more than 40 years ago. Before then, people used to have to take a ferry from one shore to the other. Why didn't they build a bridge sooner? The Ruan River is the only body of water linking the lake to the ocean. Ships have to be able to reach Grantsville, don't they? Very astute. It wasn't possible to build a bridge until after the Orbital Revolution 50 years ago. I get it. Orbital power, right? But it looks almost like it just popped up out of nowhere. The drawbridge is raised 3 times a day. Next time should be sometime this evening, I think. Cool, we need to see that. Agreed. CBCBT. Oatmeal. What do you know, Bass? They had oatmeal after all. Man, there sure are a lot of big villains around here. That's because this is the warehouse district. Cargo from the foreign countries is kept here for safekeeping. I see. Kind of depressing place though. Seems really lonely and desolate. Well, since the advent of airships, not much cargo is transported to sea here by sea anymore. So these warehouses don't get a lot of new shipment these days. Yeah, that makes sense. Is that the same? It's like some of the warehouses are abandoned too. Well, I'll see if there is any sick loot in the warehouse, isn't it? What's a bunch of kids, little kids doing here? Hey, it's Pistol Limits. You brats ain't getting into the scram. I never thinks everyone would come in. But mister, why are you so nervous? You can tell? Never mind, you're not allowed here. Just go already. I think we may need to handle this one with some care. Are we sure it's a stranger? I wonder what's up with them. Hold it, you lot. Who, us? Well, well, must be a lucky day. Not so many women folk come around these parts. Here's a real sight for sore eyes. And what business are you here? Oh, listen to that. Been here for quite a while, actually. If you find your time to spare, how about you entertain us, huh? She says trying to pick up girls in an empty old warehouse lot. Sorry, we have plans already. You know, place to go, things to see. So yeah, not interested. Feel free to go away now. I'll check you out. I like tough women. I'll take all the abuse you can dish. If your goal is to creep me out even more, consider your mission accomplished. Hey, you know, if you ladies are playing tourists, then we can show you around, huh? You can ditch that little kid with you and we'll have some fun. Hey now, who you calling a little kid? Punks like you couldn't take on Joshua if you... It's okay, it's the other mother. What good is getting angry gonna do? But... Oh, you holding back for a sec, kid? How sweet. Where does this brat get off hanging around with two hotties? Hey, I think he needs a lesson just how unfair life can be, don't you think? Just a second. Please stop. My presence is my energy, then I apologize. If you lay a finger on the ladies, I'll make certain you regret it. What? Just who do you think you are? He's just bluffing. I get it that you want to look all cool in front of the ladies. You're about to experience a world of pain. What do you think you're doing? Huh? Well, great, another nuisance. Can't believe you guys would start again with this delinquency. You're old enough to know better. You should be ashamed of yourselves. Shut up, what do you care what we do? You're just one of the mayor's yes men. How dare you denigrate my work? How dare you indeed? Gilbert's a valuable member of my staff. Downward? Whoa, who's that? He's way too well dressed for this part of town. That's Downward, the mayor of Ruin. And the younger one is Gilbert, his private secretary, I think. Ruin has always been a free city. I have no intention of lodging a complaint about your manner of speech or your attire. But bothering outsiders who may be paying guests is not permissible. Stuff it, old man. You think you're such a big shot. I'm interested in the thing you say. How dare you speak to the mayor in such a fashion? How would you like for us to report you to the Bracer Guild again? Bracer or Schmacer? Always hiding behind them. Can't you do anything on your own? Besides, not like the Bracers would get here right away. We have plenty of time to enjoy the altercation. And then we'd be gone without a trace before anyone was the wiser. I hate to ruin your masterful plan, but I'm afraid we're already here. Wait, what? Man, you mean you still haven't noticed the badges? Maybe you guys need glasses or something. With great deliberation and exaggerated movements, Estelle pointed out the bracer on her chest, then raised her eyebrows for further emphasis. Ah, crap. You guys are bracers? So wait, this little punk you're with is also a bracer, yes. What do we do now? I can't believe that little squirt is actually a bracer. You're actually worried? Even if they are bracers, just a couple of girls and some kid. Dumbass, can't judge a book by its cover, you know. Remember what happened the last time I took a chick bracer? You have 3 people shot on the floor with us. We're up against 2 bracers, even if they do not look like pipsqueaks. It's totally not a good idea. Okay, we're gonna let you off the hook for now. If we see you again, though, you'll be in for some real pain. Catch you later. Bass, I have a solution for you. Pick up the brushes. Jeez, now those are bonks. I mean, could they be any more stereotypical? No, I'm done. And don't we have somewhere we need to be? Must apologize. I live with our city's guests so bothered. Forgive my lack of an introduction as well. I'm Downward, Mayor of Ruin. And this is my steward, Gilbert. A pleasure, I'm sure. You're braces, are you not? Yep, I'm Estelle from Ronin. I'm Joshua, also from Ronin. Jean did mention some promising new faces soon to arrive. Might we have been referring to you, perchance? Haha! Well, I don't know about the promising part, but yeah, I think you meant us. Well, there you go. Job done. We came to Ruin in search of work, actually. Oh, how delightful. Had some hard times of late, you see, so any help we can get is simply wonderful. Well, that's because your cat didn't know about them. But now, they gotta stay locked away. I'm sure your presence here will be a great boon to us. Hard times, what do you mean? Well, Jean would be the one best able to supply the details. As an aside, is that a campus uniform I spy, young lady? Yes, sir. I'm Chloe Rins, second year student at the Royal Academy. It's a pleasure to meet you. Charmed. Dean Collins is a friend of mine, actually. Did you graduate from the Royal Academy yourself, Gilbert? Bad cat. Yes, sir. You said your name was Chloe? Well, I've heard a great deal about you. You ran against Jill for head of the student council, right? Aren't you proud to have been a contender as a junior? Oh, you flatter me, sir. Ha ha ha. I'm looking forward to the campus festival. I trust you'll be giving you all to help make it a memorable one, though. Yes, sir, I absolutely will. Post an impact, sure. I'll take a look. Well, I think we best be going. If those ravens start making trouble again, feel free to drop by and let me know. It's my duty as a mayor of Ruin to ensure that these streets are safe for tourists and residents alike. How dare you, cat. Why, he was certainly a dignified one. Yes, indeed. His manner and actions were perfectly suited to the mayor of the city. House Dalmore is made up of a long line of well-bred aristocrats. Though we no longer have real nobles, he's about as close as it gets. Wow, it's like he's from a totally different world. On the other hand, though, you still have all the lowlifes like those guys who tried hitting on us. Yes, that was quite unsettling. I'm very sorry for leading you into such a place unprepared. No need to apologise. It's not like we sort them out or anything. We should probably keep our distance from the back end of the warehouse district though, to avoid any further altercations. Well, I don't like being restricted like that, but whatever. Right. Hopefully I can go back to the guild now! Come on in, welcome to the Bracer Guild. Oh, Miss Rins. Afternoon, Jean. You here for another extermination request? I know. Security's been tightened for the campus festival. No, but I'm sure we'll be here for that at some point. Today I'm just visiting with Stella Joshua. Oh, I see. So they're civilians, are they? I suppose they shouldn't know the lack of student attire. Wait, there's emblems. Pleased to meet you. I'm Estelle, Junior Bracer. I'm Joshua, also Junior Bracer. You did hear extermination. Oh, so you're Estelle, Joshua. Wow, so good that you're here. We've been waiting for you ever since we got word from the Bose branch. Ah, old man Luper must have sent word of us. We'll have to thank him. My name is Dean. I'm the receptionist for the Ruin branch. I'll be supervising you two, as well as providing various types of support. It's a pleasure to meet both of you. Pleasure's all ours. Indeed, it's good to meet you, sir. Haha, I have high hopes for you two. After all, you were the ones who so magnificently handled the Sky Bandit incident. Sky Bandit? You mean that incident in Brazil? I read about it in the latest liberal news. Did you guys really sort that whole mess out? Ahaha! Well, it just helped a little. It was the Royal Army that really did the work of apprehending them. Don't be so modest. Lugan had nothing but praise for you. Now, to change your assignment, I need you to sign the appropriate forms. Let's go ahead and take care of that now. Okay. Might as well get out of the way. Alright, two of you are now part of the Ruin Branch. Welcome aboard. Been so busy, you couldn't have picked a better time to come. Haha, now you can't get away. Well, I don't feel like I just signed my life away. Looks like you're as short-handed as we heard some time ago. Something in particular going on? I wouldn't say that exactly. We're expecting a member of the royal family to visit, though. Member of the royal family? Well, you're not talking about the Queen, eh? Haha, no, of course not. I just know that it's someone of royal blood. I've heard that he or she will be giving Ruin a thorough inspection, though. Huh, that's kind of cool. But why would that cause you to be short-staffed? Because it's a member of the royal family. If even one thing is out of place, Male Damwon will be worried sick. So most of our staff was requisitioned to help strengthen security. I get it. That's what was being discussed upstairs earlier. Police in the streets, right? Yes, I feel certain that the crew at the harbour will be back in action pretty quickly. I want the city to be hooligan-free during the royal visit. Crew at harbour? You mean the guys you dealt with earlier? I had the feeling they were up to something. What? Do you know something? Actually, Stella and Joshua described what transpired outside the warehouse district. Ah, yes, the warehouse district. That's the turf of a rather unsavory group calling themselves the Ravens. Imagine you encountered some young men and their leader there. Huh. I wonder what those Raven characters are up to. They've been fine until recently. Whoever's in charge needs to tighten the leash. The mayor's main concern, though, is that we cover the whole area. And that's why we're so short of staff right now. Thank goodness you two are here. Ha! Well, it's nice to feel wanted. Guess that means we've got a lot of helping out to do tomorrow. If anything happens, just say the word, we'll help out. I will, thank you. Wow, it's already evening. Look at that gorgeous sunset. That it is. All of the light shines off of the streets. Haha, I've always loved it too. Oh yes, summer's time. For what? That really is a masterpiece. How long does it stay up? 30 minutes, really. It's raised in the early morning just before noon, and in the evening, and it isn't lowered again until all the ships have passed. See, so then there's usually no foot traffic. Haha, I admit, it's easy for a first time to get confused. Well, that reminds me. What are you guys planning to do about lodging? Well, the second floor of the guild is always an option, although I could really go for a luxurious hotel. Well, I think I might want to hurry and get a room. This is tourist season, so they tend to fill up pretty quickly. Alright, no time like the present then. Yeah, let's go. I'll have to remember which one it is. Not that one. It's a big one, I think. Hello, welcome to Hotel Blanca. You have a reservation with us? No, we were hoping that... Do you have any rooms available? Impeccable timing, sir. We have just had a cancellation for the room on the top floor. Please, Jerk, show it to you now. Penthouse, sir? That could be nice. Is that going to be expensive? Since it's empty due to cancellation, I'd be happy to charge you the standard rate. Not to mention your hidden bracers. I'd consider it an honour to serve you for the harbour you can protect our citizens. Hehe. Well, when you put it that, like that, how could we refuse? So, yes, we would like the room. As you wish, sir. Haha, well that was a stroke of luck, wasn't it? Anyway, I think I'll go back to the campus for the time being. I won't make it back before the dorms are locked. If I don't hurry. Oh right, you said you could only stay out until evening. I hate to see you go, but I understand. Would you like us to escort you back? Oh, it's alright, I know the way. Thanks for letting me come with you today. Oh, come on, we should be thanking you. Yeah, we really appreciate you playing tour guide for us. Oh, that's no big deal. And you two are going to be in Ruin for a while, right? If you are, I was hoping you'd come to the campus festival at the end of the next week. A festival? Given the Royal Academy's reputation, I'm betting it's more than just balloons and party games. Yes, it's an independent, Academy-sanctioned student celebration. It's a major tradition, really. Okay, now you got my attention. Would I have stage skits and food stands? Would I have chocolate-covered palms? Maybe. They rid about all the stops. Oh yeah, I'm so there. I mean, I'd love to join you for the preparations. Now hold on, Estelle. Did you forget how busy we heard the guild is? Man, that again. Aww. Still, I guess you can't hurt to take a bleh. But until then, we've got work to do. Haha. Well, if you're both part of me then, I'll see you again soon. Sure, see you later. Be safe. Such a sweetie, yet she's all dignified. If I were a guy, I'd be completely wrapped around her finger. Your painfully obvious illusions aside, she certainly seems to be a genuinely nice, guileless girl. Definitely unlike some sneaky sky planet I can mention. Me and her sure was lucky. You even got a sweet room for her here thanks to her advice. I bet we could even spot sleep with the view we have up there. Haha, you might be right. Well, how about we take our bags out to the room? Penthouse room, you mean? Oh, that's damp. Wow, it's enormous. And this is just the bedroom. Not only the top floor, but an all-out suite. I would have been just fine with the regular room, though. Well, I think we should enjoy it while we can. Wow, even as a balcony. Yep, check out this view. I just hate that we're the only ones to get to enjoy it. I was hoping that Dad would be here. Yeah, I don't know where he is and what he's doing. Well, wow, isn't this all posh? What was that? Sounded like it came from inside. It's spacious and well-appointed. Yes, I like it. I'll take the room. Please wait a moment, Your Grace. I'm afraid that this room is not vacant. Perhaps you could stay at the Mayor's estate as originally planned. Hush, Philip! I can't even see the water from here. There, even. This hotel has a much better view, and I can smell the sea air as well. I can even go out on the balcony. But who are you people? Are you thieves, or are you here to kill me? It's a horrible thing to assume about someone. Besides, who are you, old man? You have no right to be in here. How dare you call me old man? Very well, so you are the ones renting this suite. I'm going to be using it as a private room during my stay in Ruin. I suggest you leave. You say what? I don't know what you're talking about. But it's any reason why we should have to leave. I think you really deserve to hear an explanation. Bah, I shouldn't have to deal with you ignorant commoners. You don't realise who I am? Nope, no clue. All I see is an old man with a weird looking head. Weird? No reason to be rude, though. At least say unique or something a little more positive. Oh, I get it. It's all in how we say it. Grr. Fine. Clean out your ears and listen well. My name is Dunan von Oslis. I'm nephew to Queen Alicia II, granted the title of Duke by Her Majesty herself. I see your astonishment has robbed you of the ability to speak. That's to be expected. One more reason do you need to give up the room? Ha ha. You're hilarious, old man. I'm dying here. You're supposed to be the Queen's nephew? That's not nice to laugh like that. Maybe he was just telling a joke, you know, to ease the tension. Please pardon my interruption, but His Grace speaks the truth. Huh? Perhaps I should have been quicker to speak. I'm the Duke's personal butler, Philip. He's been under my care since the time of his birth. I assure you that all of this is true, on my honour. The man before you is indeed Duke Dunan, nephew of Her Majesty the Queen. I can't believe it, but never mind the weird rich-looking guy, but the butler seems legit. Suddenly reminded of something Jean told us. He said that the royalty would be arriving in Ruin to inspect the city. Haha, will you submit now? I'm next in line to succeed the throne, and you should be honoured to give me your room. Such an opportunity is afforded to commoners quite rarely. You gotta be kidding. You're royalty, but to me you just act like an aggrant old man. Miss, please, you must wait. Huh? Please hear me out for a moment. Pardon my impertinence, but I would ask you for a favor. Could I persuade you to relinquish the room? The elderly butler produced a large sum of mirror from his breast pocket and presented it. Mr. Phillip, you'd do that? Disgrace is the type of man who would not be swayed once he's begun speaking. Fear this trait may even be due to the negligence on my part. So please, please. Your butler bowed his head before Estelle and Joshua. Well, I guess that's that. I don't want to cause the butler any trouble. You can have the room. And you don't need to pay us. But it's fine, really. It really is a little too fancy for us. I'll bet looking after that guy is a hassle, but hang in there a bit. Madame, you have my deepest gratitude. Hey, what are you whispering about? Oh, nothing important. Please pardon our intrusion. We'll give the room over to you. Ah, you will? Haha, I've only been so humble to begin with. You'd do well to retain that mindset in the future. Oh, what a total Now, if you excuse us. Really? Even if you explained your situation to the Duke, he probably still wouldn't have taken no for an answer. I'm really sorry that you had to deal with that. It's really no big deal. If there's anyone to blame, it's the selfish Duke guy. That said, do you have any of the rooms? The regular room would be just fine. Well, maybe just booked the last room a short while ago. Ugh, I think we just got played for suckers. No need to fret, we're at fault here. I'll see to it that arrangement made for you elsewhere. Yo, what's the deal here? Hey guys, I haven't seen you since the site Bannet hideout. Mile? Good evening. Wouldn't have expected you to see you here. Look who's talking. Didn't think you two would show up in ruin. Anyway, what's up? You got problems? Well, Stell and Joshua explained the recent turn of events. Haha, you two getting the damnedest situations. It's not a laughing matter. Yeah, don't get your knickers in a twist. Stay in my room. Huh? My room's some extra beds. Hey, clerk or concierge or whatever, you don't mind, do you? Not at all. In fact, you'd be helping me immensely. Sounds like a plan, then. The room's on the basement floor. Follow me. Are we okay with this? Well, he offered, so it should be alright. You may want something in return for this, though. Probably something way out of proportion, I bet. Well, I guess we're kind of stuck. Alright, save before we go into his sex dungeon. Oh, good you're here. Grab one of the unused beds and make yourself home. Appreciate you giving us a place to stay and all. The gracious host thing is a little much. Oops, sorry if I'm acting suspicious. I'm just grateful that you guys helped me nail a great story earlier. I just wanted to take you back, that's all. You mean the Sky Bannet article, right? Did you get much of a reaction? Oh yeah, it was a big hit. Our readers loved that article on Colonel Richard in the Intelligence Division. I get the feeling that we sold more copies because of him than the Sky Bannet incident, to be honest. Huh, is he really that popular? Rumour has it he's about to get a big medal from Her Majesty. It's getting to be just about all people will talk about. I'm actually going to have an exclusive interview with him. Well, that's impressive. Well, he's got the looks and brains to credit. He puts people at ease. That's all. What's wrong? There's nothing to worry about. That story netted me a tidy little bonus. Let's hear it for finally getting rid of my bad luck charm. Colonel's one heck of a guy. By bad luck charm, do you mean Dorothy? Speaking of whom, she's not with you? I was only looking after her for a while. Looking after her while she's learning the ropes. That big story meant the end of our mighty team. Still, it worries me to think she's gone off on her own. Kind of trying not to think about that. I just want to enjoy a nice vacation with the bonus I got. Shouldn't you be chasing the next big scoop? Or are you checking on that Duke guy who kicked us out? Ah, Duke Doonan. Our own walking catastrophe. From everything I've heard, he's a real Adonis. More so than most of it, anyway. Rumour has it that he even drives Her Majesty up the wall. Sounds perfectly believable to me. He said he was next in line to succeed the throne. Seriously? I don't want to have to call that fat jerk my king. Well, given Her Majesty's age, it's not unreasonable. Plus, there's the fact that her son died some time ago. A lot of people would be opposed to it, though. Guessing you don't know much more than we do. Which would mean you're chasing a different story, right? Ha! Bullseye! Man, I can't think anything past you kids. Yes, you're right. That's all I'm saying. This one's just too big. I don't think you're overstating things at all. But hey, whatever. It's not like we go shouting it from the rooftops. Look forward to reading it for myself. Oh yeah, just leave it to me. By the way, have you two had dinner yet? I'll take her out and treat you both. Seriously? Thank you very much for your generosity. That night, Nob bought dinner for Estelle and Joshua at the casino and bar called Laventar. After a meal consisting of some of the best seafood from Azalea Bay, and drink in Niall's case, the two brought the now unconscious Niall to the hotel and set him in his bed to sleep it off. Oh, is this the... Oh. Haha, I suppose having this much sewing to do is proof that the children are full of energy. Well, it'll all wait till morning. Now I'd best get some sleep myself. Please watch over them tomorrow, adios, and keep them safe. What was that? What's that noise? Sounds like someone put wood on the fire. That smell. Can't be. Wake up, everyone. What? I didn't do anything. Huh? I'm still half asleep. Danielle, Polly, wake up. What's going on, Mr. Teresa? I'm kind of scared. There's a fire. Everyone up. What? Really? Go downstairs now. Everyone stay close to me. Oh, what the heck? It's all smoky. I'm scared. Sleepy. Come on, hurry to the exit. Ah! Yep. No. Radios, I don't care about me, protect the children. Fuck. Fucking arsonist who fucking burned the orphanage ruin the following morning. Wait, hold on. Oh man, my poor aching head. That must be one heck of a hangover. It's kind of impressive the way you drank the whole bar, though. Sure you okay? Want some water or the bucket again? No, I'm good. I got an event to cover. Oh, really? Well, thanks for taking us in yesterday. Both very grateful. Just pass on anything interesting you hear to me. I'll be in room for a while, too. Okay, see you later. Oh, God, why is this light so bright? Well then, we'll say we head to the guild. Mind by me, we'll see if Jean's any work for us. Where's the Orion Causeway? Let's go to the arbor. Ah, the Orion Causeway. Are you hard? Yeah, that's me. Oh, are you guys racers? Yeah, that's right. Did you happen to lose a warehouse key? Yes, I did. I was working with the barrels around the crane the other day. I guess I must have dropped somewhere around there. I was waiting around to have a drink at the Aqua Rosa. Probably dropped it in that area. Once I got to feeling good and toasty, I decided to take a walk around here. You were wandering around the harbor drunk? What if you dropped it in the water? What if you fell in the water? What do you expect? I couldn't resist the ocean air, you know? Well, talking isn't getting us anywhere. I'm gonna figure I must have dropped it somewhere in the harbor. I guess you got some walking around to do. Indeed. Sorry, I'm not trying to make your lives any tougher. I've got to get back to work. Let me know if you find it. And please contact us if you think of anything else. Yep, you bet. Shining below us. Something in the water. I don't know what it could be. It's hard over here. Maybe we can check it out. What do we do? Can't exactly dive in and have a look. There's something hooked snagging it, maybe. Yeah, they're fishing world. Do we have a fishing world? The crane. It's gonna be easier if I just look it up, isn't it? Alright, warehouse key. Alright, bear with. Fisherman, all the fish in my store are caught fresh by me. I think I'll boat earlier. Not sure I want to boast, but you don't find fresh fish anywhere else in Ruin. Think we could borrow one of these? I'll have to ask the shopkeeper. Our time is on the first floor. Oh, right. No, welcome, welcome. Hey, we saw you had some fishing rods upstairs, but remind me if you borrowed one? Oh, not at all. Just say the word and you borrow one anytime. Just bring it about whenever you're done. You get that key. No. Excuse me. Looks like someone dropped something. Check it out, might be useful. Maybe you should pick up the turn to work. Oh, I know. But I get it, you're gonna try fishing out. It's not gonna be difficult. Heh, just you sit back and watch the magnificent Estelle at work. Fine, fine, do you please? Check me out, I got it. Pretty impressive. I didn't have to admit, I didn't think you'd be able to do it. Hey, that's not really the same as congratulating me. But check it out, this looks like the warehouse key that Mr. Harvey's talking about. No telling how it got dropped there. Let's bring it back to him. Okay. Right, arg. Hey there, Mr. Hogg. Whoa, keep your voice down. How is it gonna find me out? Oh, oopsie. Anyway, about that key. Oh, that. Handsome. It's the key, right? This is it. Yep. No bones about it. Hey, thanks, you guys. You really saved my skin. Say, why is it all tied up with fishing line? It was kind of a long story. Well, no big deal. I got a split. Thanks again. Okay, let's go to the Oriole Causeway next and we'll do that. Nut boy. Okay, Joshua. What a stinker. Oh. Joshua, I'm like pooer. Just like we promised. No study video, any assignments for us? Ah, music to my ears. Let's see, there's so many options. Go easy on us. Oh, hold on just a moment, please. Hello, you've reached the Bracer Guild. Oh, it's an incoming communication from the White House, White Magnolia. How unusual. I'm impressed you were able to reach us without all comm equipment. What did you say? See, that's definitely a major issue. Yes, I understand. I'll send someone over shortly. What's wrong? Another case? Could be a case, or just an accident, I'm not sure. Last night, the orphanage on the coastal code caught fire and burned down. No way! Any idea who might have done it? That was the proprietor of the Minoria Inn who called. Are you too familiar with the Mercy Orphanage? Familiar? We were there just yesterday afternoon. Are the kids and the matron okay? That I don't know. We have to conduct a full investigation that has to be as thorough as possible. Would you be willing? Of course we would. Set over there now then. Good, good. Take care. Oh boy. Oh. To say fuck it to the serious music then. Orphanage burnt down. So it's... it's somewhere along here. What in the... There's been a Mordor. Fuck. Right, so we're looking for some guy's gun or something. Deathblow 2. Electric Boogaloo. What a bitch. Eat this food. Holy shit, stop kicking the shit out of us though. My god. What the fuck? There's been a murder. beware of monsters. I think I need to get there, actually. The moth boys. It's the moth boys. What the fuck are you doing, Josh? You stupid pig. Why don't you attack? Uh-oh! He's okay. Hey Morgan, how's it going? I'm doing very good, thanks for asking. How are you doing? The fuck? Oh.
Not now.
Okay, don't fuck a chance for you. Right? Yeah, I'm fun with it.
We're good to go.
Thanks for asking. It's pretty hard for me to not enjoy an RPG, I'll be honest. There has to be like something seriously wrong for me not to. Oh, I can't It's a camera. Get that rock shark thing. Yeah, I know. It's great, right?
God. Yeah, step into the circle. Oh, actually, don't you have, you have Ariel now. Oh! Oh! No arts for you. Aw, you fucker. What the? Oh shit, don't use physical. Josh might die here actually. No, he's okay. Just. Steady on. I love that piece. Green. Oh my god. Run away? Ah, oh, his thing's gone. Fucking shadow spear, this motherfucker.
Alright, we're good to go.
Ooh. Oh, they both leveled up. Cloak and Dagger. Zero type test model. Oh, is that the... Oh, did I just kill two things with one stone? I think I did. Wow, okay. Let's head back then. Can you do it? I've been here for 10 years already. You're starting to creep up on you. Here from Zeiss to market research to all powered firearms. Warring Causeway is caught up with some extremely aggressive monsters. An extremely important prototype model that I was trying to break the bugs out of. Oh, it's still a bulletin board. So we lost this orbital gun thingy? Yes, that's correct. If you should find it, I beg of you. Is this the prototype gun? Whoa, how? How did you get your hands on this? A monster near the Sephiroth Tower had it. Probably wanted it for the Septium mechanism. In Elliot's name, thank you so much. Oh, thank goodness you found it. Now we've fulfilled your request. Pardon us, we must be going. Why are you in such a hurry? Please, at least take this with you. Just taking on my appreciation. I wish you luck on your future endeavours. Thanks. Attack 2, you say? Ooh, flare arrow. Ooh la la. Still single, but like me. Seems to be stone related. Or not? Earth Lance. While that is cool, I think having the higher grade heal is better. let's go rest. Then I'm gonna go buy some items and essentials just to be safe. Unless I can make some. To buy anything, no? Make 10 of those. Okay, now that the orphanage burned down and we like wasted a bunch of time doing anything except help them, let's go to the burned down orphanage. Oh, we can test Joshua's new skills too. Cloak and dagger. Ooh. Very cool.
You bitch.
I can't remember where it is, I think it's through the Minori village. I gotta try flipping dagger. It's kinda cool. This is terrible. It's just gone. Well, what do we have here? Are you from the Bracer Guild? Yeah. You're from Minoria, right? Yeah, we came to help pick up the pieces. We were here last night around midnight trying to fight the fire. As you can see, it could have gone better. So then, what about Matron Teresa and the kids? They're all fine, don't worry. Right now they're sleeping at Minoria's Inn. Given the size of the fire, it's a miracle that no one was badly hurt. Thank goodness. Yes, at least that's something. We're here now to clean up what we can. How about you two? We really ought to check up everyone at the inn. Sorry, but I'll have to wait. Huh? Now that we're here at the scene of the crime, there's a lot that strikes me as weird. We find what clues we can for the trail gets cold, so to speak. Now you feel, but this has to take precedence right now. Right, we're British after all. Let's find out what happened. Right, let's see what we can find. Looks like you'll have your hands full. Good luck. Herbs have been uprooted and strewn about the garden. Odd. So often the flower bed is all over the ground. The milk tank has fallen outside and is empty. The barrels of food in them have been scorched black. What was once a wall is now rubble. Wow, this place is ruined. Hey, you smell something strange? Yes, I think I know why. The door has been completely wrecked. That's all pitch black. Huh? What's wrong? Maybe this is just me, but doesn't the hinge look weird to you? Like it's been torn off or something. It does actually. As if it happened before the fire started. Because we're not reaching around the garden. Firewood for the stove would scatter around. Taking a good look around. What do you think? Not sure, to be honest. First off, the fire doesn't appear to have started in the building. Most likely started outside. Outside? Over here. Except the area is the point of origin. Ah, the wall collapsed. How can you tell? Because the fire damage is worse here than anywhere else. Compare it to the areas nearby and you'll see. Oh, you're right. So it started here and then spread. You know what this means? Well... Someone set the fire on purpose. My thoughts exactly. That smell everywhere is some highly flammable oil. It's everywhere around here, so this had to be the fire's point of origin. No way. Plus, don't you think it's weird how everything outside is scattered around? Even the people fighting the fire wouldn't have done that to the herb garden. It's not a coincidence. Someone did this. Is that true? Chloe? I didn't know you were here. But why? Why would anyone do this? I have so many irreplaceable memories of this place. Why? How? How could someone do anything so cruel? Chloe. I'm sorry. I'm just so confused. You're not alone in that feeling. I barely know the place, and this bothers the heck out of me too. It's hard to believe that anyone could be capable of something this awful. Still. But the matron and the kids are all okay. So we could be thankful for that, right? Thank you, that does help. I just started morning class when the dean came to see me. He said that he heard the orphanage was in flames. And while I was on my way here, all I could think about was they're fine, they're alive, adios, watching over them. Well, we heard that they're all at the inn in Minoria, safe and sound. We just finished up here, so we're planning to see them. Do you want to come with us? Yes, I would like that very much. Alright then, to Minoria we go. Mation, everyone. Miss Chloe, you came. Is anyone hurt? We're okay. I is okay. Thank goodness. I'm glad you're here. Is that Estelle and Joshua I see with you? Yes, since someone contacted the guild. We're investigating the incident and thought we'd stop by. I see, thank you for taking the time. Investigating? You mean about the fire, right? Do you know who did it? Well, how to put it? So, who's hungry? I missed breakfast, so I was thinking about getting some food. Good boys and girls who join me will get sweet treats. Really? I just want some pudding.
I just want some pudding!
But... come on, Clem. Huh? Quit griping, come on. Let's go downstairs, Miss Chloe. Oh, okay. Ooh, that was close. I really want the little kids to hear about this. Indeed. Although I get the feeling that Mary understands that they saw what's happening. Yes, isn't she great? Happy to have her around. Now, you were saying? Please tell what you can. Thanks for your understanding. Okay, then. First we checked out where the fire started, and it does appear that it was set deliberately. My suspicions were correct, then. I've always been very careful about fire, so I suspected it might be something like that. Do you have any idea who could have done this? Whoever is responsible must have had some kind of motivation. I have no idea. We have no real money to speak of, nor has anyone ever borne a grudge against us. So it wasn't a robbery, and it wasn't for revenge. We have to acknowledge the possibility that someone did it just for fun. Did you happen to notice anything unusual leading up to or during the incident? Any strange people hanging around the orphanage, for instance? Yes, actually. Not during the daytime when you were there, but afterward. Though I can't imagine he would do some of this. Who's he? While we were trying to escape from the burning building, the beams fell in and blocked our way through the entry hall. But then he showed up and helped us all get free. We owe him our lives. Really? Was he a Minorian? After he helped us, he called the villagers and left in the confusion. I asked the other villagers about him, but no one seemed to know anything. Sounds suspicious. What business would anyone have around an orphanage at such a late hour? Did you notice anything particular about him? He was a man, maybe in his late 20s. He also had brilliant silver hair. Silver hair. He had a troubled look about him, though. That made him seem far older than he looked, but he didn't strike me as a bad man. Sounds suspicious, but he did help you out. Doesn't sound like a guy to me. Joshua? What's with the goofy stare? Oh, it's nothing. Perhaps he was just a bracer who happened to pass by? I think that we should disregard it as a suspect. Okay. Pardon me. Oh, hi, Chloe. Where are the children? They're downstairs having some dessert. Mission Teresa, you have a guest. Pardon my intrusion. Oh, Mayor Dalmore. Oh, so the bracers I met yesterday are here as well. Dean's reputation for responding quickly is well earned. Now then. It's good to see you again, Mation Teresa. After I heard what happened, I came over as quickly as I could. I'm glad that you're safe. Thank you, Mayor. It's very kind of you to come by. I know you're a very busy man. Nonsense. It is my responsibility to look after all areas of the region. More to the point, those who did this must not be allowed to get away with it. Joseph always loved that place. Such an atrocity. Now I'm to express my most heartfelt condolences. Thank you. But I'm sure that he would just be relieved that the children are alive as well. My sole regret is that all my mementos of him were lost to the fire. Mission Teresa. Tell me, Bracers. Have you any thoughts on who might have done this? We've only just begun our investigation, so it's too early to say, sir. It does look like it might have been done simply out of malice, however. I see. What a terrible thought. For something so heinous to happen in such a peaceful place. Pardon me, Mayor. What is it? Do you think that those people might have had a hand in this? Whoa, hold up. What do you mean by... who do you mean those people? You encountered them yesterday. The ruffians down in the warehouse district of Ruin. Oh, them. Pardon my bluntness, but what makes you suspect them? They've been openly defying the Mayor for quite some time now. They certainly seem to get their kicks out of causing trouble for him. Since he and Mason Teresa are friends, Gilbert. Sir. Wild speculation does no one any good. This is a dire offence. We must have no false accusations. My apologies, sir. That's foolish of me. I think it would be best to let the bursts identify and locate the ones responsible. Can I count on your help? Sure, leave it to us. We'll devote our full attention to it, sir. Good, good. Glad to hear it. By the way, Major Teresa, I do have one question to ask. What is it? What do you plan to do with the orphanage now? Rebuilding will take time and not inconsiderable amount of mirror to complete. Honestly, I'm at a loss. We have a modest reserve mirror, but the cost will be phenomenal. Matron, I was afraid of that. Well, I have a proposal of sorts for you. What might that be? At the Dalmore Estate in Grantsill, I have a villa. It's only used for special occasions, so what say you to having the children stay there for a little while? Oh. And of course, charging rent would be particularly boorish of me. You'd be welcome to stay there for as long as the rebuilding process takes. But well, there's no need for you to shoulder the burden of our troubles. But the villa sits unused. If you have misgivings, then I'll grant you control of the grounds. Think of it as a well-deserved reward, if you will. Mayor, may I have some time to think it over? Your offer is misgenerous, but I can barely process it with everything going on. Perfectly understandable. You should get some rest. I must be off as well. If you decide to accept, please feel free to contact me. I will. Thank you so very much. Let's go, Gilbert. Yes, sir. Silver hair. Wow, that was a shock. He's certainly the generous type, on par with Mayor Maybell. Silver hair. But it was a man, it's not Scheherazade. Olivier had blonde hair. Agate didn't have silver hair. Indeed, particularly in light of his being a former noble. What do you intend to do in regards to the mayor's offer, Matron? Well, what do you think of this situation? Conventional wisdom dictates that you should accept it. However, once you've gone to Grantsill... never mind me. You're always such a thoughtful child. It's alright, I want you to give me your best opinion. Honest opinion. Her garden and the people I care about would be gone. So, with you and Joseph gone, I feel like all of my good memories will fade away. I'm sorry, I'm just being stupid and selfish. I share your feelings. The orphanage is home to my memories of him as well as the children's memories. But their memories are precious. Having a place to live is of the utmost importance. Yes, ma'am. I believe this will all be settled soon. Please try to focus on attending the campus festival for now. The children are really looking forward to it. Yes, ma'am. Stan and Joshua, I wish I could be of more help, but I must leave the investigation in your hands. We'll handle it, ma'am. I'm going to take the culprit down. You can count on it. This sure has turned into a royal mess. Where should we start the search? Maybe we should go to the guild and report back to Jean. We can figure out a plan of attack then. Sounds good to me. Something wrong? You look like something's bugging you. I'm sorry. Mine's just all over the place right now. I know how you feel. By the way, Joseph was Major Treason's husband, right? Yes. He died several years ago. But he meant a great deal to me as well. I see. Wait, does that mean you're for the orphanage too? No, nothing like that. He just did a huge favour for me a long time ago. We grew close again when I came to Ruin to attend the academy. Oh, I see. In other words, every time you came by to play, you ended up helping out with part of the family. Yes. He was like a father to me. But the shock I experienced was nothing compared to that of the matron and the other children. But we managed somehow. Miss Chloe. Mary, what's gone into you? What got you into such a hurry? Listen, Clem's gone. Huh? You don't mean he's left Memoria? Can you give some more details? Okay. After that old man showed up, Clem went upstairs. In a couple of minutes, he came back down all red in the face saying, they're not getting away with this. Then he just ran off. I wonder who he meant. You didn't suppose this... Yes, I believe it was the Ravens. Probably overheard what the steward said. Oh no, I hope he's not planning to go and find him himself. It can't be. I can't allow this. I have to find him at once. We'll come with you. If we hurry, we might be able to catch him before he gets to Ruin. Miss Chloe. Don't you worry, I'll bring him back safely. You just look after the other children, right? Okay, good luck. So back to Ruin. Alright. Good night. Ruin. Excuse me. Yes, this way. Oops. Ruin, here we come. They served him on the way. This place is already there. Come on, check out the warehouse to the south. Damn, it's almost noon already? No. Clem, please wait. It's no use. Guess he can't hear you. Crap, what does the bridge have to go up now all times? Can we wait 30 minutes? Oh no, we need to do something. What do we do? What can we do? Please, Chloe, try to calm down. I haven't forgotten what you told us about the bridge already, right? Huh? Now, how did people get across the bridge before it was built? By boat! That's right. If I remember correctly, there's a boat you can rent behind the hotel. Alright, we'll use that then. To get here? No. How do I get behind the hotel? I have to go into the hotel, I guess. Can I talk to this guy? Pardon us, Mr. Manager. You rent out a boat, is that correct? Yes, just go down the stairs and take a right to where it, get where it is. Downstairs to the right. Thanks. Oh, probably here. What do you want? Can we rent your boat? We need to get across as quickly as possible. Afraid not. That Duke fellow's already reserved it. Maybe come back later? Oh, no. Please, won't you help us? There's a little boy in grave danger. Now, don't go shedding tears like that. You might be my granddaughter. I don't like to see her upset either. But alright, I suppose it can't hurt. Go ahead on board. Thank you, sir. You're a lifesaver, mister. I'll just tell the Duke fellow that the boat's being repaired. Do you know how to handle a boat, boy? Yes, sir. I'll manage. Come on with you. It's the southernmost part of the warehouse district. Okay, I understand. Looks like he's gone as far as in as you can go. Let's get a move on then. That's probably where we'll find the hideout. Watch that. Okay. Save you some good time. Go beat up some boys. I'm trying to play dumb. I know it was you guys that did it. I won't let you get away with it. What's the point talking about? Hey, this isn't a place for little kids. You wanna go home and get back to sucking on your mum's tit? Ha ha ha! Nice one, man. Grr. What the? What's the brat so pissed off about? I don't have a mum, you jerks. I have the matron. You don't get to make fun of her. Heh. You got a lot of attitude, punk. We need some discipline. How about 100 whacks on the ass? Ha ha ha. Stop this. It's you. Mr. Chloe? How can you be so cruel to a child like this? It's disgusting. You should be ashamed of yourselves. Oh, hell no. Hey, Missy. Who are you to look down on us because you have looked, rich snob? How embarrassed do you think it'll take to be us? Stand aside, Chloe. Buy some time. Get the kid as far away from you as you can. No. Let me fight, please. Huh? I really didn't enjoy it, but I was taught how to use a sword if it's to protect others. I think now's the right time. What? Self-defense rapier? Let child go, please. Otherwise, I'll force you to do so. Oh, wow. That's so hot.
Get your minds out of the gutter and focus.
You expect us to let this brat get away with mouthing off to us? We're the ravens. You need to learn not to mess with us.
Alright, yeah, come on!
OP? This woman is Shirayama. I'm gonna cast it here. It's gonna be a while until she has a turn again. Let's see what this does. Wow, strength and defense down. Talk about OP. Don't bring me that easy. Oh, he's getting angry. Fucking angry boy over here. Oh. Fucking little angry boy over here. You guys are some kind of monsters. Even if she is a racist, there's something weird about this chick. That was awesome, Miss Chloe. Nice game, Chloe. Must have learned the art of the sword from someone very skilled. No, I'm just a novice. Fighting any longer would serve no purpose. Please release the boy. You bitch. I'm just gonna let you make fools of us get away with it. Enough. But who's there? Reinforcements? Oh shit. Has it been so long that you've forgotten my voice? A gate! You're here. What are you doing here? You know these guys? Race. Yeah. What are you fools doing? Fighting with girls and beating up a little kid. Is that what it's come to? You shut up. You left us. Who are you to give us orders anymore? You were saying? Hey, Gate, take it easy. If it's about the kid, we'll let him go, see? Goodness, you're right now. Should have just done that from the start. A bunch of mean jerks. Hey, how did you know exactly when to show up? I just talked to Gene, is all. He said the newbies were somewhere investigating the arson case, so. Hey, kid. What? You got some guts to come up here all by your lonesome, but you're really pushing your luck. You shouldn't worry your mama like that. Come on. Matron? Why have you come here? Inquired at the guild as to what was going on, and I was led here. Clem, really, you know better. I'm not apologising this time. I'm gonna get those jerks who start the fire.
Clem!
Major Teresa, please don't scold him. That wasn't my intent. I understand how you feel, Clem, believe me I do. House was important to everyone who lived there with you, to all of us. However, getting yourself killed will not bring it back. All that I want is for everyone to be safe. Nothing else matters. So please, don't put yourself in danger. I'm such a sucker for this stuff. I'm really glad he's okay. Jeez, women and kids always the same. Hey, racer kid. You should get the matron and brat out of here. It's really no place for them. I don't mind, but what would you do, Agate? Made up my mind. I'm gonna remind these idiots who runs things and why. Money to crack a few skulls. No, please take it easy on us. I see. Guess you prefer not being interrupted then. Thanks so very much. I wish I had the words to express my gratitude. You really don't need to thank us. We're just doing our jobs. Still, are you sure you don't want us to escort you back to Minoria? Yes, it's fine. The Gold Seaside Way is like my backyard after all. More importantly, I don't want to get Chloe in trouble at school. No need to worry. I will accept full responsibility, Matron. Thank you, Chloe, but it's fine, really. I want you to focus on preparing for the campus festival. All of the children look forward to it. Yes, ma'am. Oh, made it just in time. I brought back the boat. Thanks. Sorry for making you do that on your own. Don't worry about it. It wasn't a tough job. I owe you my gratitude as well, Joshua. It's Chloe. Well, you guys, actually. Thanks for helping me today. I was stupid. Really stupid. I thought maybe I could get back at them. And then you had to come to save me. You must think I'm a complete loser.
True.
We don't think that at all. You're not a loser. What? You risked life and limb to protect something that's important to you. That's no mean feat, even for grown-ups. Personally, I thought you were pretty awesome. Mr. Joshua. However, you need to leave fighting to the criminals to us. Your job is to protect the matron and the other kids. No one else can do it. You have to stay with them, encourage and support them. You're the only one who can do it, then. Only I can do it? Okay, I think I get what you're saying. You think you're up to it? You betcha, you can count on me. Thank you yet again. Take care, everyone, if you'll pardon us. I'm Miss Chloe. I can't wait to see the play. Great, I've been working hard on it, so I hope everyone will be there. You can count on it. See you later. Just fucking get Olivia to fucking snipe the kid. Glad to see he's feeling better. Sometimes you know just the thing to say, don't you, Joshua? No, I can't believe my eyes seeing how quickly Clem showed up. Thank you, Joshua, so much. No, I didn't say anything special. You gotta protect what's important to you, that's all. Anyway, I'm just glad he's okay. Thanks for your help, Chloe. Thanking you? Oh, by the way, what came of your investigation? Oh, well, that red-headed dude butt is spiky-headed now, so I wonder if he's done yet. But now, let's go back to the guild. Come with us, Chloe? Yes, I'd like to find out what's really going on. Not to mention the identity of the arsonist. Well, let's go then. Oh, actually, is there going to be any weapons in here for Chloe now? Aha!
Saber.
Welcome back and good work. I'm told that you're able to save a young boy. Yeah, somehow or another. Still kind of in shock from when that redhead showed up. You must mean a gate. He's working another case of ruin. Used to be the leader of the Ravens, if you could believe it. I suspected as much. Guess that explains his terrible disposition. Well, that was a long time ago. He drifted into town right around when he was your age, hung out with a rough crowd and got into some serious trouble. Compared to back then, the tough types nowadays are puppy dogs. And a guy like that was allowed to become a bracer? Well, I got to know him a little bit. It turns out that he wanted to become a bracer ever since he was little. Sometimes people just change. I think that's probably enough of the idle chatter. Oh, you're back. Didn't your mum ever tell you it ain't nice to talk about somebody behind his back? Always with the gossip. But is it really gossip if it's positive? Anyway, you done with your investigation? Yep, over and done with. Can't say for sure, but I think they're clean. Really? You're not just trying to protect your old buddies? You wanna watch that mouth of yours? From what I saw last night at the Sailor's Tavern, they couldn't be the arsonists. Hell, I doubt they could have even walked a straight line if they wanted to. Well, if that's true, we can hold off on them. They didn't strike me as the types with the guts to try arson anyway. Guess not, just follow themselves mostly. All you need is to give them a nasty look and believe me, they'll cave. Anyway, I'll see if I can find the arsonist while I'm out in the field. Huh? I'm taking over the case and you're off it. Whoa, say what? You might be kidding me. Can you at least give us an explanation? I don't get your panties in a wad. You two are too close to this case and you know it. If you let your feelings run away with you, it screws your judgment. Plus, you let a Siffy get involved. Oh, pardon me, but you gotta apologise, it's these two I'm worried about. Point is, you've got to be professional about it, and these two ain't. Just where do you get off calling us unprofessional? No matter what you say, you've been opposed to the mayor. Hey, Jean, what do the rules say about when junior and senior bracers want the same case? Oh, come on, you know as well as I do. Of course it rules in favour of the senior bracer. I'm not bad in a fight. Perhaps we can provide backup? It's just an investigation, I don't need more people. I think we're done here. Try not to hold this against me. What? Who the hell does he think he is? It's frustrating, sure, but he has a point. It just irritates me that we really don't have a counter-argument. I'm sorry, but I had not drawn my sword. That's not what's bothering me. He doesn't have to just blow us off like that. Please, he means no harm, don't be upset. Tact is not a strong suit. He just doesn't know any other way to communicate. Particularly in light of the current situation. I think it may have something to do with an early case of his. He was pursuing someone and, well... Pursuing someone? Like a criminal? Ah, never mind about that. I really can't go into detail. Just let him handle these criminals. Consider it a personal favour for me. I guess you had no choice. Let's see. Well, we'll hand over our report from our investigation then. Please go ahead. Seems you were quite thorough. But as I mentioned, the circumstances of the case are special. Terribly sorry, but you have to end your investigation here. But I just wanted to do something for the matron and the kids. This isn't right. Still. Mr. Jean? It's possible to enlist the help of the Bracer Guild for civilian events, isn't it? Yes, though it would depend on what kind of event you're talking about. Because of the number of people who attend, we'll be handling security at the Royal Academy Festival, for example. Well then, Estelle, Joshua, would you mind helping out with our play in the meantime? Huh? What do you mean? Every year when the festival ends, there's a play held in the auditorium. I know the children always look forward to it, and there are still two major roles that have been filled. You don't mean... you want us to take the parts? Yes, otherwise we may have to cancel the play entirely. I can't bear to think of how disappointed the children would be. So I mentioned you two to the student council last night. They seemed quite eager to have you. It wouldn't be much, but you'd be reimbursed in the admin budget. Why do you want us? I don't think I'd be any good. And isn't the play a really big deal? Well, for the girl part, we need someone who's been in combat. I think you fit the role perfectly. I see. Well, I could definitely do combat stuff. Sounds like it would work. What about the other part? Oh, yes, well, talking about it is kind of what? Embarrassing. And what does that mean exactly? What kind of play is this? Oh, come on, Joshua, you're not going to make a say, are you? We can do something for the kids, what's the harm? Plus, if we do some work, they'll probably let us have some of that awesome festival food. Kind of an opportunity to slip by. Hey, hold on a second. Dude, is this really a legit praiser assignment? It certainly is. Since an outreach and regional services comprise plenty of the general work that Bruce is doing. And since the gates showed up, you do have some extra time. I certainly have no problem with it. Alright. Oh, I have a bad feeling about this. But if it's for the kids, what choice do I have? Still, if we have anything else to do, we should take care of it beforehand. I doubt working on the play will leave us free time for anything else. You're probably right. Hey Chloe, would it be okay with you if we looked around some more? Sure, you don't need to worry about me. To get to the Royal Academy, we leave by the Gold Seaside Way and go east at the first fork and then follow the wooden path. Okay, got it. Well then, let's go. Oh, shit. Joe Biden. More like Joe Bidet, am I right, guys? Mr. Tobias, came here from the guild. Oh, it's about the maintenance kit, no? Time is exemplary. Will you be able to make the delivery post haste? Yes. This brick of a thing is all yours now. Brick of a thing? Are you daft? I'm telling you, it's heavy. Very, very heavy. Here, fit for yourself. Okay with it? No bone fractures forming, or to your knowledge? It's filled to the brim with replacement parts and every tool you can imagine for replacing an orb light of that size. It's no big deal at all. I'm stronger than I look, believe me. Just to carry this to the lighthouse, right? Indeed. To Voch! The lighthouse keeper. He's expecting it. Its contents are quite valuable, so please be as careful as you can. I still can't believe it. Such responsibility, such strength, such grace. Ah, youth. What? Jean told me about you. I'm seeing for myself just now how peppy you are, let's whisper it to this guy. Peppy? No. We're just a professional? You're young, that's what you are. And naturally, I was worried entrusting something so valuable to potentially reckless youths, but I worry no more. Maybe young, though, doesn't automatically mean reckless. Oh, no, you got it all wrong. I just meant that I wasn't sure how old man Voch would take it. Oh, why do you say that? Is there something we should know about him? Well, you might say he's a bit of an eccentric. Be a little abrasive when it comes to younger people. So in other words, he's a weirdo. That's one way to put it. Just try to understand where he's come from. Being a lighthouse keeper is lonely work, so a little eccentricity is to be expected. The lighthouse is crucial for ships to be able to navigate safely, so the keeper's work is a very big responsibility. Gotcha. So really important work. When he hears a fisherman, he used to down plenty of drinks at Laventar. Now that he is at the lighthouse though, he rarely gets a chance to have his favourite drink. Pretty sad. I'd like to go ahead with getting him what he wants, but I probably said too much. Either way, don't let the old man's unpleasantness get to you, okay? Okay, got it. Is there anything else before we go? Nothing in particular. Once you're done, I'd like to return here. Take care, and I'll see you later. Right, let's go to the chapel next, then. I saw you guys the other day. Nice to see you again. Oh, hi, you're the guy we met on the beach, right? You can call me Jimmy. You really saved my skin before, so let me thank you again. So, have you checked out the little hood today? Well, yes. But why in the world did you pick here to meet you with places? Well, I kind of stand out, don't I? It means it costs a lot to put up one of those requests, and I figure people will see me here and ask, hey, why are you in the chapel? Then I'd be like, so that you can help me find some awesome treasure. Well, then how about we get down to business? My quest here certainly sounds intriguing. Glad you agree. Yep, I actually just acquired an ancient map shop a while ago. And you wouldn't believe what I've told you. You wouldn't believe what now? These are the treasure of the great pirate Shimmer. What? No way. But I don't even know who that is. You've never heard of Shimmer? Aren't you from Ruin? Or wait, are you from someone else? Anyway, Shimmer, how can you not know? Don't go making assumptions. If memory serves you correctly, Shimmer was a pirate that used to work in the waters around Ruin around 100 years ago. Precisely, nicely done. They visited the Royal Academy to teach the right things. Shame about the uniform though. Wow, you know a lot, Chloe. Come on, Estelle, it's not that impressive. It's just the story I heard, that's all. I'd like to ask you to look for Shimmer's treasure. Location is marked on the map. Do you remember where I was when we met before? It was a pit in a sandy beach. Go Seaside Bay, right? Exactly. The map has that pit marked. Is that why you were there? That's right. I was conducting a field survey. Since I found the place, monsters started showing up. So I figured that I should get some professionals to take over. So what's next after the pit? The map shows an X to the southeast of it. Figured that's got to be the location of the treasure. You might be right. Oh yeah, I need to make a note of this. Well, let's take a minute to work out a plan. Go to the beach in Ruin, find the pit, and go directly southeast from there. Well, that's that then. Did a great job. Thank you. Will we ever find it? All we know is to look southeast from the pit. Yes, and considering how wide the beach is, that still leaves a large area to search. Yeah, we just don't have enough information. Hey, come on guys, stop getting all negative on me now. If you comb every inch of that beach on Gossy Subway, I'm sure you'll find it somewhere. So in other words, treat it like a test of endurance. Sounds right up your alley, Estelle. Well, I suppose you're right. Still, it wouldn't hurt to have just a tiny bit more to go on. It's not the most efficient way to go about it, but what other choice is there? We'll just have to search the beach from top to bottom and hope to find something. I guess you're right. Okay, if we find anything, we should let you know. Count on you. Any treasure we find, we split equally. Yeah, we'll see, kid. I can vaguely remember where that pit is. It wasn't this screen, it was the next one. Oh, excuse me. Southeast. Oh, I'm not gonna spend all this fucking time just running around in the fucking water. Like a knob. Oh. So this guy lied. Not this guy's in the guy's thing. The guy's in fucking Jimmy. Oh, how did I not fucking see this before? I should have just opened the map. I'm blind. Look at this shit. Skull daggers and a torn map. Wow, awesome daggers. Seem pretty ancient. Look at them, they may even date back to the oral revolution. Well, what about that piece of paper? Looks like a piece of a sea chart. Do you think maybe this is the treasure that Jimmy's talking about? Sorry, I don't think there's anything to do with it. I'd say this probably washed ashore from somewhere else. Could have been cargo from a shipwreck. Yes, I believe you're right. I heard that such accidents happened not often long ago. Oh, so before airships everyone traveled by water, right? I wonder if there's beaches right on the old trade route or something then. Oh, shit. Oh! I don't think that's worth it. It's only 3 extra damage. I'm gonna hand in this quest and then we'll save and we'll stop for now. Hey Jimmy. Oh, you're back. Any sign of the treasure? Well, we haven't found anything substantial yet. We did find a couple of old daggers and a beat up map. A sea chart. Whoa, this is big stuff. Please, let me see it. Hey, calm down. I don't want you to die of excitement or anything. Whoa, is this what I think it is? Oh, wow, this is incredible. This is one of Sherman's treasure maps. What? Hold on a second, mister. You just said a minute ago that you had the treasure map already. That had to have been a treasure map map. My map shows the location of this map, which is where the actual treasure is. This is getting confusing, but I found the chart inside a barrel. Let's not worry about that. Sometimes we just have to suspend our disbelief to get through the day. It may seem a little strange that we found a sea chart or not, but I kind of want to believe that there's something to all this. So as do I. Well, there is something to think about. As long as our client is happy, we're happy, even if we're also very confused. Oh, that's right. Hey, Jimmy, what about the daggers you found with the chart? You guys can keep this. I don't have much in the way of mirrors, so it's only appearing like an offer. Please take them. Share the mystery with me. Okay, thanks. Wow, this is really amazing. The sea chart is a spectacular find. Haha, looks like I'll be busy again real soon. Whoa, I can't stick around here. How about I take this to O'Neill to get it deciphered? He's gonna flip. Who's O'Neill? Later, thanks for your help. O'Neill? Oh, okay, now I get it. So who is he? He's not a gentleman who runs a general store. He tells lots of interesting stories, but he tends to blow them out of proportion. Yeah, I get what you mean. So I guess that's that Jimmy's been taken in by the old man's telltales. Tall tales, even. Yes, it would appear. I knew it sounded too good to be true. But if it is true, maybe that chart really is one, the one from his fish tales. It's possible. I guess it is a little mysterious. Hey, if we believe in it, I wonder if maybe it would pay off. Honestly, though, I think Jimmy believes a little too fervently. Fervently, even. Still, chasing your dreams isn't a bad way to live. Meow, 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 meow. Cool. I think that's going to be it for me for today. Tomorrow, I need to find out what the guys... Well, I know Bass is around, but I need to find out if Sam's around for some Celasta. Otherwise, I love you all. Look after yourself, stay hydrated, enjoy the rest of your day slash evening, and I'll see you tomorrow for Celasta. If not, probably more of this. Take it easy.
You know what? You
too. For regular updates.
You too. Do my outro.
What? Oh. Did you just do it?
No, I'll do it again.
Alright.
Discord! Go there for memes! Also, updates! There's a YouTube channel, that's where the VODs are! Ah! Buy shirts, merch.
Yeah?
Don't forget, right.
If you don't like Discord, there's a Twitter. Fill out the form.
This form will send you to your grave. Sign it now.
Fill out the form to get your permission slip to go to Chernobyl. Daddy and sauce is coming all over your face. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe. Rate 5 stars back in 2007.
Make sure to visit someone else's.
Make sure to visit www.com.
Could you repeat that one?
That's www.com.
Join in, Sam.
Oh, yeah.